families across America, a potential solution has emerged from north of the border. A study from the University of British Columbia gave $7,500 in upfront, no conditions, cash to 50 individuals who are experiencing homelessness, and then compared what they did with a control group that received no money. As Matt Pearl reports, they found homelessness went down. Now cities in the U.S. are attempting their own versions of the plan.
The study in this story caught my eye for the same reason it caught the eyes of so many others. How often do you see a scientific approach to solutions for homelessness? And how often do the results of that approach upend what many have thought? This story takes us north of the border, but its impact is already being felt in America.
Vancouver, Canada, is one of North America's great scenic cities, a confection of coasts, crystal blues, and Canadian air. But for Ray Bonnet Rouge, the most satisfying sights are his screens, his couch, and above all, his roof.
The warmth, the comfort. I was living on the street, and I was there for about a year and a half.
What does it say to you that you're here?
Success.
There are some in Vancouver who see in Ray enormous success.
Oh, pretty good.
His story of finding home intertwines with an experiment that could change on a grand scale how we treat those unhoused.
Vancouver is one of the most expensive cities in the world.
Jiang Zhao was among a small group with an audacious idea.
This is the first randomized control trial ever to test the impact of a cash transfer on people who experience homelessness.
It was called the New Leaf Project. They spent 1 year shadowing 115 people. 50 received a cash transfer up front of $7,500. The cash recipients spent 99 fewer days homeless and 55 more days in stable housing. They spent more money on education, food, and transit. And they didn't spend more on what some might expect.
There's actually a reduction in substance use severity over 1 year. The typical assumption is you have substance use, you have addictions, therefore you're homeless. But our evidence suggests it's the other way around.
What's going on, Calvin?
Ray struggled with addiction for years.
It was quiet last night.
He spent much of his time in the area he takes us today.
It's your choice. It's nobody else's, right?
An area where he now works to help those stuck like he was.
And then one day, I really saw who I was. I actually saw myself in a mirror, and I really didn't like seeing what I saw. Years.
Ray beat his addiction, but could never scrape enough money for rent until the New Leaf Project came calling.
A larger amount of $7,500 can put them into long-term planning, long-term thinking mode. We did not anticipate that the cash transfer will help people get into housing this fast.
Ray now works on those Vancouver streets.
Yeah, thanks.
Recruiting those where he once was to take part in the project he once joined. Then he comes home. Home where a can of corn and mac and cheese is a taste of success.
I give thanks for it every day, you know, like knowing that I had the struggle before and now being able to eat whatever I want, whenever I want. I give thanks to the big guy every day.
In Vancouver, Canada, I'm Matt Pearl.